This way, after calculating this, what is AC activity ratio denoted by AC? AC equal to IP upon percentage of color size particle. IP, what is IP? WL liquid limit minus WP plastic limit divided by percentage of color size particle is given. Liquid limit is 65 minus 29 divided by 24. We obtain 1.5. Right option is C. Now, start question number 31. What is question number 31? Soil which is formed due to the transportation by action of wind. क्वेश्चन पूछ रहा है कि जो सोइल फॉर्मेशन होती है कि जो मीन्स विच इज ट्रांसपोर्ट बाय एक्शन ऑफ द विंड से ट्रांसपोर्ट ओके जो सोइल बनती है वो कौन सी सोइल होती है. दिस इज द एलुवियल सोइल. व्हाट इज एलुवियल सोइल? व्हेन द सोइल इज फॉर्मड ड्यू टू द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ वाटर एज लाइक रिवर लेक एनीथिंग फ्रॉम विच इज ट्रांसपोर्टेड बाय वाटर देन इट इज कॉल्ड एलुवियल सोइल. इन दिस क्वेश्चन ऑप्शन डी इज राइट. What is alluvial soil? When water is soil formed due to transportation by water. Lateritic soil, when soil is formed in the bed of the lakes. This is called lateritic soil. Colluvial soil, what is colluvial soil? When the soil is formed due to the gravitational force, by transportation due to gravitational force, then it is called colluvial soil. Question number 32. It is asking range of the saturation. What is the degree of saturation, limit of this degree of saturation? Degree of saturation, what is degree of saturation? It is defined as the weight of water, volume of water divided by volume of voids. Means if water maybe degree of saturation for dry soil 0, if completely saturated, then degree of saturation may be 100. That's why limit is between 0 to 100, maybe 0 and 100 also. For dry soil, degree of saturation is 0, and for completely saturated soil, degree of saturation is 100%. Next question, question number 33 asking total permissible settlement for isolated footing on clay is limited to. Total permissible settlement on isolated footing. Isolated footing means a different column have different footing on clay. That's the permissible deflection is 65 mm. That's caudal provision of soil. There are two cases. When soil is clay, then it is 65 mm for isolated column or isolated footing. And if it is sand, then it is 40 mm. Remember, if clay are more compressible, that's why deflection is more permissible. That's why here 65 mm is permitted. And if the soil is sandy, then it is 40 mm. If soil is foundation is compounded like raft foundation, then permissible settlement on clay soil is 65 to 100. If raft, I will again explain, if footing is raft footing, then soil is clay, then permissible deflection is 65 to 100 mm. If soil is sand on raft foundation, then permissible deflection is 40 to 65 mm. On raft foundation, we provide deflection more because it's a large area, so load carrying capacity is high. To economize, we provide deflection more, limit more. These are the explanation. Four types of cases you can read from code, or I explain here. These are the. Now question number 34. The test which is not possible to be performed. कौन सा टेस्ट हम परफॉर्म नहीं कर सकते फील्ड में. दीज आर ऑल आर द टाइप ऑफ टेस्ट. कंसोलिडोमीटर टेस्ट आस्किंग विच टाइप ऑफ टेस्ट इज नॉट परफॉर्म इन फील्ड. फर्स्ट इज सेइंग अनकंसोलिडेटेड अनरन टेस्ट. मीन्स देर आर टू स्टेज इन कंसोलिडेशन टेस्ट. से टेस्ट फर्स्ट इज कंसोलिडेशन, सेकेंड इज से टेस्ट. इन सेकेंड डेवेटर स्ट्रेस इज एक्स्ट्रा अप्लाई. Then in if unconsolidated means in first stage well for pour water valve is closed. Unconsolidated means consolidate नहीं हो रहा है वो, तो valve close है initially. Then it is performed. If this is the second case is right because unconsolidated means first case में valve बंद है और second after first case consolidation stage में तो valve बंद है और second stage में जब हम शेयर अप्लाई कर रहे हैं डेविएटर स्ट्रेस अप्लाई कर रहे हैं तो वॉल ओपन कर दिया, ऐसा पॉसिबल नहीं है। अब कैसे कर सकते हैं, अब अगर फर्स्ट स्टेज में वॉल ओपन नहीं है तो फिर सेकेंड स्टेज में हम ओपन करेंगे तो वो पोर वाटर एक्सपेंड हो जाएगा, बाहर निकल जाएगा, तो वो फील्ड में परफॉर्म करना बहुत ही कठिन है, वो नहीं सकता। दैट्स वाई दिस इज दी ऑप्शन बी इज राइट। ऑल द ऑप्शन आर ऑल करेक्ट, वी कैन परफॉर्म एज कंसोलिडेटेड अंडरेन मीन्स फर्स्ट स्टेज में वॉल ओपन है, सेकेंड में हम बंद कर सकते हैं। अंडरेन मीन्स वाटर, पोर वाटर बाहर नहीं निकल रहा, पोर वाटर प्रेशर डेवलप हो रहा है, मीन्स वी कैन सेकंड स्टेज में क्लोज कर सकते हैं। सेकंड लास्ट ऑप्शन इज कंसोलिडेट ड्रेन कंडीशन, मतलब दोनों स्टेजों में वेल ओपन है, पोर वाटर एक्सपेंड निकल रहा है, पोर प्रेशर डेवलप नहीं हो रहा। दीज आर ऑल दीज आर वी कैन डेवलप, ओनली बी वी कैन नॉट एबल टू डेवलप इन द फील्ड। नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 35, पाइल विच इज वाइडली यूज इन केस ऑफ सोइलिंग, हाई स्वेलिंग एंड श्रिंकेज। आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन वाट इज स्वेलिंग एंड श्रिंकेज, अगेन आई विल एक्सप्लेन। स्वेलिंग मीन्स the expansion of soil when water content is increased, and shrinkage means decrease in volume of the soil when water content is increased, that's a shrinkage. Means he is asking which type of foundation best performed on this soil when shrinkage soil, which type of pile use. We use under rim pile, that's option D is right. What is under rim pile? If this is the pile, then extra key joint is provided here, this is under rim, this portion is called under rams. This will provide against, if the soil is like that, then this is space also provide for expansion. If the soil is expand, then it offer resistance against the movement of the pile is like upward, then it offer resistance. Pile may be single rim pile, multi rim pile. The some basic definitions, if the diameter of this is D, then diameter of under rim should be 2.5 to 3 D. Some specification you can read from the IS code or soil book as pile foundation. These are the some specification. What is end pile friction? End pile friction means this is pile, let's suppose this is pile, if these are the two rocks at this surface is hard rock, then it's transferred directly load to the end, it is no resistance, this is not considered in calculation, it is directly transferred load to the hard soil, which can hard rock, anything from hard existing. Now second case, side pile friction. Side pile friction means if this is the pile and this is soil is loose and hard rock is not available at considerable depth, then the pile is provided with sufficient surface area to offer resistance against surface by friction to the by which amount of load is applied on the pile. This is side pile friction. Concrete pile means when pile is constructed by using concrete. Pile may be different type as timber pile, steel pile, or based on material, these type based on use various types classified based on various purposes like material and load transferring mechanism. These are the three type, all these. Now question number 36, minimum camber required for thin bitumen road in light rainfall area. What is camber? First is camber. Camber is the longitudinal, not longitudinal, transverse, just like this is the if I draw cross section of road, this is the cross section of road, this is the transverse, this is running along this, this is the road direction, this is cross section, then this is slope, this is called camber. Means if I define the transverse slope provided to the road surface, or it's called camber. It is provided for the rainwater easily drain out from the road surface. Now for it is asking light rainfall for bitumen road surface, therefore it is 1 in 50. This option B is right. 1 in 50 generally provided for bitumen, 1 in 33 for concrete. If this is cement concrete to CC road instead of bituminous road, if CC road, then option C D is right. The for bitumen road, option B is right. And if it is a water macadam road, anything else, then it is like that. Anything you can see, these are the table IRC code. IRC, I think 73 is provide the various cambers. What is specification? Now question number 37, oversight distance of two-way road having divider in between them. What is oversighting distance? OSD. He asking OSD. If two-way road, this is the two-way road, this is the two-way road, one way, and divider in between means in this direction only one direction vehicle, and in this direction only one direction vehicle. So OSD, what is OSD? summation of d1 plus d2 plus d3. d1, d2, d3, what is d1, d2, d3? d1 means the distance which is covered by the vehicle in the reaction time. What is reaction time? By thinking the by the driver thinking to take overtake vehicle in this time, if a vehicle travel a distance d1, that's a d1. d2, the distance traveled by the vehicle in accelerated motion, as like this bike after starting the time, then vehicle start to accelerate and this is distance covered. And d3 is the distance which is considered for opposite side vehicle. Suppose we sight a front vehicle which is coming, then its distance also considered in calculation of OSD. But in this case, specifically saying that divider between these two way means only one direction vehicle is there. So OSD will be equal to d1 plus d2. That's option C is right. Option C is right. Now question number 38. Cross slope provided on mountain terrains according to IRC. What is cross slope provided on mountain? Generally mountains road banana bahut costly hota hai. So to economize this, we increase the slope provided on the foundation, or on the cross slope provided. So this is general IRC specified 25% to 60%. Now the question number 39, design super elevation provided on horizontal curve of highway having design speed of 30 km/h and coefficient of lateral friction is 0.15. These are given. He is asking what is design elevation. What is elevation? The transverse slope, on curves, on road curves, the outer side of the road surface is rising with respect to inner edge. This is called elevation or super elevation. Why we provide super elevation? To make comfortable, to counteract the centrifugal force of the vehicle when turn along the, suppose this is the turn, then centrifugal force of the vehicle when navigating this curve is acting outward. To counterbalance this, the outer edge of the vehicle must be raised. So the total net force will become zero, then vehicle easily navigate this curve. That's why provide in this question what is equation of the super elevation designing. Design super elevation is considered when velocity is 75% of the free velocity, means e equal to v square upon 225 r. If we calculate from here, then some of the these are the some mistake happen in the question. I think we calculate from here, does not option is a match. This is the first calculation. If for design step, these are the calculation e equal to v square upon 225 r. This is the formula for design speed. V is velocity in km/h, 225 into r is radius. This after calculating it, if it is come out more than 7%, then this is not prime. Assume super elevation is 0.7. due to some mistake in this question, I think any option is not matched. And another, if this is failed, then e plus f barabar v square upon 127 r. This is the formula of super elevation. We consider this is the formula. Now f is the longitudinal friction which is given by lateral friction given, and e v is velocity 127 r. If this is, I think in this question mistake in speed is given 30 km, does not any option is not matched. If speed is 80 km, then option b from here, calculating by putting v equal to 80 km² into 1/127 into r is 250 and f value 0.15. e calculating, then we calculate the value of this option is matched. I think this is the option right. Now this is the calculation how to design, and the IRC also specify the value of the super elevation. IRC, according to IRC, 2.7 v square. V square.
कोचिंग का कुछ है?
हाँ ऐसे
मेडिसिन ज्वाइन कर लिया?
कर ली मैंने कोचिंग, अब नहीं कर रहा।
अब नहीं कर रहा,